Hello friends, I am NKZN from Skill on Tech. Let us see cooling tower inspection part 2, common problems. Video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. Cooling tower structure. Cooling tower structure is in very important and a foundation of a cooling tower. So there are problems in cooling tower structures, which may arise time to time during operation of the cooling tower. Loose, damaged or missing beams. Means there may be beams are loose because their fasteners may loose during operation of the cooling tower. Or any of the beam may also fall due to loosening of fasteners. Loose or missing bolts. Bolts can fall in the cooling water basin. Loose, damaged or missing panels, partitions. Cooling tower cells are having partitions, so that partitions can also damage during the operation due to vibrations in the cooling tower structure. All these tower structures must be inspected very carefully, and all observations are recorded and rectified whenever shutdown is taken for cooling tower maintenance. Here you can see a picture of deck area of a cooling tower. So this deck area is very important, and due to continuous operation of a cooling tower, this deck structure may loose. So this deck structure fasteners are to be tightened time to time during maintenance or whenever opportune shutdown of cooling tower is available. Fan shroud, stack or cylinder. You can see a picture of a fan cylinder and a fan with a gearbox. So what are the common problems in fan shroud, stack or cylinder? Loose or damaged shrouds, loose or missing bolts, connecting bolts and base bolts, rubbing between fan and shroud. So you can see in this picture, if your fan is rubbing with the inside periphery of a fan cylinder, then it will make a noise and can damage to fan cylinder and blades. The connecting bolts of fan cylinder and base bolt of fan cylinder may also loose during operation. They shall be tightened or missing bolts shall be provided with the new bolts. Motor. You can see a picture where a motor is coupled with a gearbox. The motor plays an important role for driving the gearbox, and then this gearbox operates the cooling tower induced draft fan. The typical common mechanical and electrical problems arises in a cooling tower application. This gear drive reduces the high speed power from the motor to the lower speed required to power the fan. So this motor shall be checked. Motor winding condition is very important, and measuring shall be done to check the winding condition. Motor terminal box shall also be checked and inspected time to time for their perfect sealing of terminal box. Otherwise, during rain, water may enter into the terminal box and can cause a trouble to running motor. Fan drive problems, shaft or sheaves. The problems in fan drive are generally shaft misalignment, coupling problems, shaft unbalance, shaft resonance. All these problems will develop a vibration problem into the fan assembly and fan drive system. So if your drive shaft is misaligned between motor and gear box, then high vibrations will be induced and will damage the rotating components of this fan assembly system. The coupling is also play an important role and shall be checked. 4. Coupling bolts and coupling bushes. If coupling bushes are worn out, they shall be replaced. If coupling bolts are worn out or corroded, they shall also be replaced. If drive shaft is unbalanced, then it will also cause a inducing heavy vibrations in the this operating rotating system. Shaft resonance may be due to speed of the shaft. So that material shall also be proper to avoid resonance of the shaft with the speed. Gearbox. Gearbox is a very important part for operating cooling tower fan. Cooling tower fan is directly connected with the gearbox shaft. So, gearbox bearings or gears may wear or faulty. So, that shall be inspected during shutdowns. Or if any problem is observed during predictive maintenance or during inspection of gearbox, then they shall be rectified. Gearbox may have a lubrication problems due to loss of oil due to fill line failure. So gearbox oil shall be top up time to time to maintain lubrication of gears and bearings of gearbox. And if there is any problem in the fill line of lubrication, then they shall be replaced. Fan wheel, hub and blades. So this is one important assembly which is mounted on the gearbox. Fan wheel, hub and blades all are connected with each other. So what problems may be there? Fan unbalance, blade pitch problems, improper pitch or inconsistent pitch, blade elevation differences, drooping blades. All the blades of fan shall be mounted at a same elevation. If they are having elevation differences, then the fan will not work properly and will create unbalance also. Blade cracking. These blades are generally of FRP. So these blades may also occur cracks. These cracks are usually at or near hub fit, point of maximum stress. They shall be inspected time to time. Blade V poles clogged or open. If blade V poles are clogged, they shall be opened. Balance weight of fan shall be kept in place. Otherwise, that will develop unbalance in the fan assembly. Fill material. You can see a picture of PVC fills. The fill material is one very important part of the cooling tower where heat is exchanged from hot water to air. So purpose of fill material is to increase the time the hot water is exposed to the air, thus increasing the transfer of heat from the water to the air. The presence of fill material in good working order directly improve the cooling tower efficiency. So, missing, damaged or clogged fill material will degrade the cooling tower efficiency and potentially disrupt the airflow. Buildup of algae and other organic matter biofilm will both hurt the cooling tower efficiency, potentially increase vibrations level due to disrupted airflow, blade pass and increase safety concerns. Lung infection due to excessive bacteria in airflow also occur. So these PVC fills are very important and they shall be checked during preventive maintenance of cooling tower or during shutdown. If there is any damage in the fills or if any choking or clogging is found in the fills, they shall be replaced. Water piping and drainage. You can see a picture of a return header to cooling tower. So the problems generally observed are water leaks from piping or reservoirs, buildup causing improper water flow, reducing efficiency, distribution nozzles clogged or not working properly. So all these problems may be inspected and attended to improve the cooling tower, water piping and drainage system. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.